morning, everyone. Steve Georgia here from Allendale's Trading Floor. It is November 9th. It is day after USDA gives us, well, new numbers. And so we had seen some changes, some not, but most of those changes came in the way of yields. So corn dropping more than what the trade was expecting should have been looked at as a little bit friendly. Carryout numbers just above 1.7 billion, but it was the global number that was the biggest concern. China basically doubling the global ending stocks. Looking back the last 10 years with a new census report saying how much more grain they currently have. So does that matter to the market? It should really have little impact, but it is something that I think was a surprise to the market. We saw corn pull back and now we have it flopping back and forth of unchanged. It is a little lower here to start the morning. We'll see what happens here as we go through the session. Beans down a little bit here overnight as well, with ending stocks growing to over 9.5. So 950 million carryout, big, big number. How realistic is it as we go toward the end of this month? Do we shake hands with China? Can we get some kind of something put together? And what kind of reaction do we get? We're still watching headlines more than anything. We're watching what kind of deals Argentina can put together with China right now as well. China certainly looks like they're doing a lot of their business with that with South America, and that may continue right now as well. So we'll keep an eye on that and let you guys know as we continue to get these newswire stories. Other than that, for wheat, not a lot going on there. Wheat pulling back, still big ending stocks. Until we see demand pick up for wheat, we could see that continue to kind of have their bounces, but also have their struggles as well. Good export sales, though, yesterday. Hopefully, we can see more of that as we move through the next couple weeks. But outside markets, though, showing some red. We've got financial markets that are down, crude oil that's down, and that's got this negative tone across commodities. Big, big rally for the dollar yesterday. And holding that support as these Fed minutes basically coming out saying that with the economy and unemployment rate where it is, chances are very good that we're going to see more of a rate hike here as we go toward the end of the year. So probably expect a rate hike here in December to finish out the year. But the dollar is strong. It's got commodities setting back here today too. So give us a call if you have any questions. We are here to help you. You can reach us here 800-262-7538 or the web at allendale-inc.com. You guys have a great day. Have a great weekend. We'll chat again with you on Monday. Take care.